Do Pfizer and Moderna vaccines prevent SARS-CoV-2 infection? Can you transmit the virus after you've been vaccinated? And how effective are mRNA vaccines in real-world scenarios? Hi, and welcome to Microbial Minutes. This is the American Society for Microbiology's update on what's hot in the microbial sciences. I'm Ashley Hagen, Science Communication Specialist for ASM, and today we're looking at research evaluating the effectiveness of mRNA vaccines outside of clinical trials. In December of 2020, Pfizer and Moderna became the first COVID-19 vaccines to receive emergency use authorization in the United States, and the first successful mRNA vaccines to ever make it to market. Today, they're amongst a handful of additional COVID-19 vaccines being actively distributed in multiple countries around the world. Randomized, placebo-controlled phase 3 clinical trials have demonstrated that mRNA vaccines are greater than 90% effective at preventing symptomatic COVID-19, and especially effective at preventing severe disease. But whether vaccination prevents SARS-CoV-2 infection in real-world conditions has yet to be determined. In other words, we've known for a while that COVID-19 vaccines are highly effective at preventing people from getting sick and requiring hospitalization or dying from COVID-19, but we have not known whether vaccination prevents the virus from infecting people altogether, or if it's possible for people to still acquire asymptomatic SARS-CoV-2 infection and unknowingly spread the virus after being vaccinated. On March 29, 2021, the CDC's Morbidity and Mortality Weekly Report published data on the subject. From December 14, 2020 to March 13, 2021, weekly SARS-CoV-2 testing was conducted on a cohort of 3,950 frontline workers, regardless of symptom status. Only individuals with no documented history of SARS-CoV-2 infection prior to enrollment were qualified to participate in the study. The final cohort consisted of healthcare personnel, including physicians, PAs, nurse practitioners, dentists, nurses, therapists, technicians, medical assistants, orderlies, and all other persons providing clinical support in inpatient or outpatient settings, first responders, including firefighters, law enforcement, correction, and EMTs, and other essential and frontline workers, such as those in hospitality, delivery and retail, teachers, and all other occupations that require contact within 3 feet of the public. 75% of participants received one or more doses of vaccine during the study. 2,479, or 62.8%, received both doses of mRNA vaccine, while 477, or 12.1%, had received only one dose of mRNA vaccine by the end of the study. Vaccination status was confirmed through self-report, electronic medical records, and direct upload of vaccine card images at 8 U.S. locations. Which vaccine was administered varied based on time and availability of each product. 62.7% of vaccinated individuals received the Pfizer vaccine, and 29.6% received Moderna. The remaining 7.7% were still pending product verification at the time of publication of this study. There were two major components to the design of this study: active surveillance for COVID-19-related symptoms and weekly PCR testing for SARS-CoV-2 infection. For 13 consecutive weeks, participants were asked to keep track of and report any fever, chills, cough, shortness of breath, sore throat, diarrhea, muscle aches, or loss of smell or taste that they experienced. They were also asked to self-collect weekly mid-turbinate nasal swabs and ship them on cold packs to the Marshfield Clinic Laboratory in Marshfield, Wisconsin, where all samples were tested for the presence of SARS-CoV-2 RNA via RT-PCR, regardless of whether or not the patient was exhibiting symptoms. In the event that COVID-19-related symptoms did develop, an additional nasal swab and saliva specimen were collected at the time of symptom onset and tested in the same Marshfield Clinic Laboratory as well. Over the course of this study, 205 participants in total were diagnosed with SARS-CoV-2 infection by RT-PCR. 87.3% of these correlated with cases that displayed symptoms of COVID-19-associated illness. 2% correlated with cases that displayed symptoms inconsistent with the study's definition of COVID-19-associated illness. And 10.7% reported no symptoms at all. 2 hospitalizations and 0 deaths occurred during this study. Individuals were considered partially immunized 14 days or more after the first dose of vaccine and fully immunized 14 days or more after the second dose. Immunity was considered indeterminate during the 13-person days in between partial or full immunization. 161 infections of SARS-CoV-2 were confirmed by RT-PCR during the 116,657-person days of this study when participants were unvaccinated. 33 infections were confirmed during the indeterminate period and were excluded from analysis. 8 infections were confirmed during the 41,856-person days when individuals were partially immunized, and 3 infections occurred during the 78,902-person days when participants were fully vaccinated. The incidence rate for partially vaccinated individuals was 0.19 per 1,000-person days and 0.04 per 1,000-person days for fully vaccinated individuals. Estimated adjusted vaccine effectiveness was therefore 80% in partially vaccinated individuals and 90% in fully vaccinated individuals. Here are a few key takeaways from today's session. We know that mRNA COVID-19 vaccines have demonstrated greater than 90% efficacy at preventing symptomatic COVID-19 in phase 3 clinical trials. Data now also indicate that mRNA vaccines are 80% effective at preventing SARS-CoV-2 infection 14 days or more after the first dose, and 90% effective at preventing SARS-CoV-2 infection 14 days or more after the second dose of vaccine outside of clinical trials. This data represents some of the first large-scale evidence that mRNA vaccines are effective at preventing SARS-CoV-2 infection in real situations where the risk of exposure may be higher than normal. And reduced infection suggests that vaccination also limits viral transmission and is important to controlling the spread of SARS-CoV-2. So that's the latest on what's hot in the microbial sciences. As always, it's important to remember that this data is preliminary. New information about COVID-19 vaccines is being produced regularly. So keep seeking current and reputable data. And don't forget to subscribe to ASM's YouTube channel and ring the bell for notifications every time we have a Microbial Minutes update. I'm Ashley Hagen. I'd like to thank you for listening and thank Ray Ortega for production. I'll talk to you next time.